Now let's map the many-to-many relationship between animal and food item. Now, the first stage is you have to map the non-relationship attributes as usual. So the non-relationship attributes are the attributes which are not the foreign keys. So this three over here and this three over here. That's what I done over here. The second stage is adding the relationship attributes. Now animal can have many food items and a food item can be consumed by many animals. So we introduce a list over here instead of a singular attribute like food item. So there is a list on both sides and there is a many-to-many relationship on both sides. So the third stage is a bit different from the other mappings we have seen so far. The third stage, instead of a foreign key column on other sides, we now have a table containing the foreign key, which also serves as its primary keys. So for this, we have to use a join table annotation. We do not use a join column annotation because there is no join column in these tables. We use a join table because they are joined using a table. So there are three members in join table annotation. The first is name, second is join column, and third is inverse join column. Now the join table annotation can reside on any side. It doesn't have to be on animal side. We just selected animal side randomly. For the name member, you have to mention the name of the table. The name of the table joining table is animal food items. That's what we mentioned over here. For join column, you have to mention how it's joined on this side. It's joined using animal ID foreign key, which pertains to the primary key animal ID over here. So for join column, the name is animal ID, which relates to this, and the reference column is animal ID, which relates to this. And for this side, we use inverse join column. Now inverse join column has join column with the name item, food item ID, which pertains to this, and the reference column name, which pertains to this. Now in our case, we have used the foreign key and the primary key with the same name, so there is no much confusion over here. And on the other side, you just have to use the map by attribute like before, so it's mapped by this attribute over here. Just to make the mapping more clearer to you, the table join table name is mentioned over here. For this side, animal ID serves as the primary key foreign key, so animal ID is mentioned over here, and its related primary key is mentioned over here. For this side, the food item ID is mentioned over here, and the related primary key is mentioned over here. So let's start coding for many-to-many relationship. First step is map the non-relationship attribute, which are all of these, and already done that. There are three attributes over here, there are three attributes over here. Now the second stage is adding the relationship attribute. It's many-to-many relationship from both sides, and both sides are lists, they are not singular items. So go here. So there's a many-to-many relationship, and there's a many-to-many relationship on this side too. Now the third stage is introducing the join table annotation on one side and introducing the map by attribute on the other side. So let's go over here, and there's a map by attribute. It's mapped by this attribute and it's mentioned over here. And then there's a join table annotation with three members: name, join column, and inverse join column. We already seen how it's mapped. Now let's auto generate the many to many relationship using the ID, the class from database. So uncheck this and let's select animal food item, and let's select this also, the joining table. Next, uncheck this as of now. Let's use list as our collection. This is generic collection, this is a set. Let's see our generated tables or generated entities. So animal has a many-to-many relationship with a join table annotation. There is, as you can see, the join table can reside on any side, and there's a many-to-many annotation with map by. The map by attribute has this value. It's mentioned over here. Now let's try to auto-generate all the entities which we have studied till now. Entity classes from database. So select all of them except for the wet and its subtypes. Category, this, this, and this. Add Next, uncheck this. Let's use list as a collection. So you can see all the entities are auto-generated first. Now you realize, once you understand what all these annotations mean, it's just a simple process of using the ID to generate it, or basically the underlying provider to auto-generate the entities. This few annotations we haven't seen so far, we'll be studying it next. So as I said, not all auto-generated names will be as you want them to be. So basically a cage consists of an animal, not an animal ID. So let's refactor, rename it as animal. Then in the category table, this is fine, all seems fine. Animal table, animal belongs to a category, not a category ID. So let's change this, refactor. Now food item table, food item has supplier, not a supplier ID. So let's refactor, rename. And then in supplier table, supplier is a food item list. List is okay for a collection name. And after changing these names, you can either auto-generate the getters and setters or just make changes to the current getters and setters. Let's make it proper. It's better to auto generate, I guess. So do this for everything which you have changed. For like food item has a supplier, right? So supplier over here, and then supplier over here, get supplier instead of supplier ID. This seems more proper than setting a supplier ID for a food item. Now let's start entering data for the relationship. So here I'll be entering data for the one-to-one relationship. First we create an animal instance, then we assign some values to it, we create a cage instance, we assign some values to it. So basically a tiger instance has been created and some values for the cage also. Now in one-to-one relationship, or basically in any relationship, you have to hook on the relationship from both sides. If the relationship is bidirectional, remember all our relationships were bidirectional, so you have to hook up the relationship from both sides, otherwise the values won't get saved in the database. So cage.setAnimal and the animal, and animal.setCage. If you forget one side, you basically your relationship doesn't get saved, and then you persist both the entities. Now let's deploy our application. After deployment, as you know, because it's a singleton and it's annotated with startup, and because this is annotated with post construct, this method is going to run. So there's one error over here. Oh, I deleted the gender class, gender enum type. So let's remove this, save, and then let's deploy the application, run. So let's see if our tiger and G3 have been saved or not. So it didn't give me any errors over here. Go to the workbench, see the animal table, select, and let's go down, and there's a record for tiger. Let's see the cage, select rows, and here it is, a new record which we just entered. Now let's enter data for the one-to-many relationship. There is one-to-many relationship between category and animals. So let's create a new animal. Now for category, I do not create a new category because I had previously entered some data. Category with an ID of 1 belongs to mammal. So I just find that entity and it's stored over here. Then animal, as again you have to hook up from both sides. If the relationship is bidirectional, you have to set the relationship from both sides. So animal.setCategory, and with this category, and category.getAnimalList.add, and the animal is added to that list. Okay, and then we persist just the animal. We don't need to persist, this is an already existing entity. So let's save it. Let's run the application, which will deploy it. And let's clear the screen. So the application is run. Now let's see the output. So here you can see there's a new row added with the category ID of 1, which stands for mammal. So before we start entering data for one to many or many to many relationship, basically any relationship involving a list or basically the many side, for that it's better that you create an empty list beforehand like this. So that if a new instance of animal is created, this list isn't empty at the start. Okay, otherwise you can get a null pointer exception. So same thing we'll do for this, same thing we'll do for this, same thing we'll be doing for this. Save it. Let's see in workbench if the data has been entered. Select animal, and you can see animal added with the category ID of 4. Let's see if 4 is the amphibian category. So select rows, and as you can see over here, there is another record with category ID of 4. Let's account for the many-to-many relationship. There's a many-to-many relationship between animal and food item. So let's assign two food items to this animal. So we create a new animal, we assign some values to it, we create new food items, and then we have to hook up from both sides since our relationship is bidirectional, and basically all our relationships till now were bidirectional. So deer.getFoodItemList.addOats and oats.getAnimalList.addDeer. So it's hooking up from both sides. And so for this, veggies. And then afterwards, you have to persist all of them because we want all the three entities in our database. So let's run it. Run. Let's check our values in the database. Let's close everything off first. Let's see animal, and here's the deer, and food item, here's the oats and veggies. And if you see the joining table, you'll see some relationship joining them. For example, deer with 8 and 9. So deer with 8 and 9.